try to determine the following region in the complex plane first, and then look in this video whether you did it correctly. So we are looking for points z, such that the norm of z minus 3 is bigger than the norm of z minus 1 plus 4i. So how are we going to find those points? Well, you could try to plug in some values of z, but that's of course not really what we want to do. So what do we do? First, we set them equal. We look at the boundary. So we look for equality first. And then to simplify, to avoid square roots later on, you can square left and right hand side. So you look for z minus 3 squared in norm equals z minus 1 plus 4i squared in norm. Next step, substitute z equals x plus iy on the left hand side and on the right hand side. Then on the left hand side you get as real part x minus 3. So you get x minus 3 plus I times y and then norm squared. And on the right hand side you set z equals x plus iy. So you get an x minus 1 from the minus 1 over here plus I times y plus 4. And again norm squared. Well, the norm of a complex number squared equals the real part squared plus imaginary part squared. So we get x minus 3 squared plus y squared over here equals x minus 1 squared over here plus y plus 4 squared. And then we just work out the brackets. We get a x squared minus 6x plus 9 from the first term, leave the second term. On the right hand side, we get y squared minus 2x plus 1 from the first term, and y squared plus 8y plus 16 from the second term. And then we see, hey, that's nice. Something is going to cancel out. X squared cancels out. Y squared cancels out. Put all x's to the left. So you have a minus 6x and a minus 2x that yield together a minus 4x. Put all constants to the left. We have a 9, a 1, and a 16. So that yields a minus 8 on the left. And then we're left with an 8y on the right hand side. We can solve for y. Y equals minus 1 minus x over 2. And then we recognize that this boundary is exactly a line in the complex plane. So our region S will be on one of the sides of the line. But will it be on the up or on the lower side of the line? You can see that by plugging in, for example, z equals 0. Then you get here 0 minus 3 in norm equals 3. And here norm of minus 1 plus 4i equals square root of 17. 3 is not bigger than square root of 17. So 0 is not in your region S. And your region S should be the lower part of the line. Now, is the line itself part of the region S? As you see here, you have strict inequality, so not equality. So the line is not part of the region S, and that's why it's drawn here in a dotted way. So there you have your region S. And this particular example, as an extra, you can also see geometrically why the region S is as it is. Because what do we have? We also drew the points 3 and 1 minus 4i. And then this inequality over here means that the distance, or take the equality here, that means that the distance from a point z to 3 is the same as the distance from a point z to the point 1 minus 4i. So you're looking for points for the boundary that are equidistant from those two points. So of two points, you look at the points which are equidistant from those two points. That's of course a line in between them. So in this case, you can also see geometrically why you have the correct answer. Now, let's summarize the essential steps. First of all, you have to do some algebra to recognize that you get a line in this case. If you have some other mesh, you may have a circle or whatever. So you have to recognize what's that. Then, second step, you have to be on the correct side of the line, on the correct side of the boundary, by, in this case, plugging in some point. And then third step, don't forget to exclude the boundary. Check whether your boundary is part of your figure or not.